guys, today I have some more cards to share with you all. And once again, this is not going to be a tutorial, it's just going to be a card share. I've been making a lot of cards for, I don't even know how long, maybe last few months. I didn't film a tutorial on them, so I just wanted to maybe share some inspiration. If you have seen my part one to this video, I have shared some Gorgeous Girls cards, so they're more like on the girly side. But these ones are going to be more sort of masculine cards. So the first one I wanted to show you is this one. Now, if you don't live in the UK, you may not really understand this card. But there is a comedian here in the UK that has this sort of catchphrase kind of a thing. And whenever he thinks someone is sort of good looking, that's what he says. He says, "You're bang tidy." Which I find it quite funny, and my husband finds it quite funny as well. And so that's why I made this card. And it's really funny, really, because I didn't have any intention on making a card that said this, but I had some jewelry from Primark. And I have another one here to show you guys. So this one came on this chain, and it was from the men's section in Primark. I guess this is men's fashion, I'm not sure. But they had these two. They had the boom and the bang. And I really wanted to use this for crafts because this is not something I would wear or my husband would wear, really. But because they were on a sale, they were down from £2 to £1. And because I had them anyway, I wanted to use it. So when I was looking at the bang, I was thinking about what could I do with it that would make like a kind of a cool card. Then I remembered the saying, and it really isn't going to be funny. If you guys don't know the comedian that I'm talking about, Keith Lemon, but if you know who I'm talking about, you might find this quite funny. Anyway, so this is one of the cards, and this is kind of a masculine card, and I kept it very simple. I just wanted the sentiment to be the focal point of this, and in fact, this piece here is the focal point. So on the inside of the card, I haven't done anything. I think I might still adhere some white cardstock to this just so that I can write my message, or I might use a white gel pen or something like that so that it will stand out a little bit better. So that's the first card. The second card is also quite masculine. So this is the one here, and it basically just says, "I love you." So the background on this is quite busy, actually. I've used some Tim Holtz paper, and I did a lot of inking. So I have some blue colors, some pinks, browns, greens, all sorts of colors. I was kind of experimenting with the inking and seeing what sort of result I would get. So I used that for the background, and I also used some of the Tim Holtz tissue tapes on sort of random areas of the card. I also used some staples to sort of add a little bit more of interest. So I've got some here, I've got some here. And then I created sort of a tag on the bottom here. This was already pretty much a tag, but it was a little bit longer. So what I did was I cut out around the shape, and then I just made the tag a little bit shorter. I then used some alphas here. So I just wanted it to say, "I heart you." And I wrote forever here, and my handwriting is really bad. But this card is for my husband, so he doesn't mind if it looks like that anyway. So then I stamped this little hat, which is from a Inka Tinka Doo stamp set. I stamped it, cut it out, and used some glossy accent on it. I used some glossy accent on quite a lot of things here. I've got on the heart, on this little card that was already part of this tag. I've also got some on these charms that I've made. So this one is a little car. This little cameo of a gentleman wearing a hat. And then I've got this little charm here. And I also used some of this jute string to just add something to it. I didn't want to use ribbon on this one. So that's what that one looks like. And I have a Tim Holtz ticket here as well, by the way. And then the inside's still like that. So I might add some of the white card to this one as well. So that's that card. Next is a Father's Day card, and the one I did looks like this. So I used the mustache in the center, and I did this by inking. And if you guys want to see a tutorial on how to do that, maybe leave me a comment down below, and when I have some time, I'll probably do that if you guys want to see it. So just let me know. And this is a very simple card as well. I've used this paper on the background, and this is from a Prima collection. I'm not even sure which one it is. And then I've used some of these pieces as well, which is from the same collection. So it looks like that. Then here on the top, I just embossed the word happy. And then down here, I used some alpha stickers to write day. And the alpha stickers were actually brown. And it was blending in too much, so I used my gel pen to go over it and just color this white so it stands out a little bit better. I used alpha stickers in the center here to create the word daddy as well. And these actually look a bit textured, I don't know if you guys can tell. And what I did to these is I inked it with the Picket Fence Distress Stain, and then I heat set it, but I did it straight away so it kind of bubbled up like this. And what I did after is I just used some distress ink just to give it a bit of a distressed look, and it looks quite cool. I like that. And then I've used this penny farthing charm, and I attached a chain to this here. I don't even know why I did that, but I thought it looked cool, so that's what I did. And the inside just looks like that, so I might need to add some cards to that one as well. So that's that card. Next is this Get Well Soon card. And this umbrella is from a Gorgeous Girl stamp. And this is the Puddles of Love. So I still have her here. So it's this one. And the actual set comes with the umbrella as well. So you can stamp that separately. And as you can see here, I have a couple here that I've already paper pieced as well. So I can use for other cards. And so this one, I made it into a sort of more of a gray, light brown kind of a tone. And I just think that that looks a bit more masculine. And because this was a three-word sentiment, I decided to stamp them in separate pieces and attach them to the umbrella. So very simple, but quite effective cards as well. I really like how that looks. And I used some baker's twine on these little tags. So I tied a really tiny little bow. It looks like that, so the inside just plain as well. Now I have two more cards here, which I think I will include in this video. I don't want to make a separate video just for two cards. So the first one is this one. And this is, of course, a sorry card, and it could be sorry for anything. But I wanted to use the cherry paper, and this is from the Happy Days collection by Paper Mania. I remember seeing a card on a Google search many years ago, and someone had made a card with a strawberry on the front, and the sentiment said, "I'm very sorry." And I thought that that was such a cute idea, and so I wanted to sort of take that inspiration and make something of my own. So this is what I come up with. I am cherry sorry, so it's a play on word as well. And I haven't seen anybody do this with the cherry, so when I thought of that idea, I thought it would be a really cute card. So that's what I did. I've used a variety of papers on the top to create the buntings, and I just cut out the shapes myself. It's just simple triangular shape, really, nothing fancy. Then I used some alphas on the top as well. Here I've used some glittered stickers from Making Memories, and it looks really, really sparkly. I really like that. I've also used some baker's twine and on top here as well. And I just created this little sentiment thing here. And I really like this card. I think it looks really cute. It's really adorable. And I really like the play on words on this as well. So yeah, and the inside just looks like that. And that is that card. And the last card I wanted to share is this one. So I wanted to use this jar, which is from the Dear Lizzie collection. I have the 12x12 sheet that comes with the all the different jars. I don't know if you guys are familiar with that paper collection, but it has all of these cute little jars that you can cut out and use on a card. And I really wanted to use that on a card, and I wasn't sure what I was going to do with it. So I ended up making a congrats card. And of course, you never know when you're going to need one of those as well. So I just kept it very simple once again. I've used some baker's twine on here. And I just cut out the shape for the background, and then I added some ribbon as well. And they coordinate with the paper, so I used those. I also used some glittery stickers to create my sentiment. And then I added some colorful buttons in the center of the jar. So it looks like that. I think it's really fun, really cute, and very simple and easy to make as well. So those are the cards that I wanted to share with you all. And once again, I would love to hear which one is your favorite. So leave me a comment down below and let me know which you like best. And thank you all so much for watching. I'll catch you guys next time. Bye! I hope you liked this video. If you did, please don't forget to subscribe to my channel so that you can receive updates when I post new videos. And also, if you could take a minute to click the like button, that would really help this channel and show some support. Thanks for watching. Bye!